In the previous video where I created a pencil holder, I performed a circular pattern of fit point splines for the sweep profile. It was pointed out to me later that patterned instances of fit point splines do not adjust accordingly when the first spline changes. Thank you to Xerxes for bringing this to my attention. Before I begin, this is meant to be a quick follow-up discussion to the previous video, so I will not be going deep into the details of every single step. In the previous video, I created the first fit point spline at the top, and then I performed a circular pattern to add in these two. If you attempt to drag on the spline points, you will notice that the patterned instances do adjust. However, if you attempt to adjust the spline handles, the handles on the other two splines do not follow. So this is going to be a problem if you need to make changes after the fact. I do want to apologize to those of you who attempted to make changes and met with these issues. So here is where the control point spline comes in. It turns out that control point splines do not share the same problem. I recently learned a great deal about control point splines from a video by Austin Shaner. I will post a link to his video in the description. Do check that out. I took some inspiration from that video on how to dimension a control point spline. Generally speaking, control point splines allow for better control and flexibility compared to fit point splines. Let's start fresh with a circle. First, let's put down a vertical construction line from the origin. This will serve as a guide for the control point spline. Go to Create, Spline, Control Point Spline. After some experimenting, I found that in order to create the shape that we need a minimum of 5 points. Snap the first point to the circle. The third point to the end of the construction line. And the fifth point to the circle. Start a symmetry constraint. Select this point, followed by the opposite point. And lastly, click on the construction line to make it a line of symmetry. Repeat the same for this pair of points. Let's make the spline tangent to the circle. Because of the symmetry constraints that we put down earlier, the opposite side would also be tangent. Instead of spline handles, we have control frames. Dimension these as you would a normal sketch line to fully define the spline. Perform a circular pattern to add in the other two splines. If you adjust the control frame, the control frames of the patterned instances adjust accordingly. This is in contrast to the spline handles of the fit point splines, which do not adjust accordingly. From here, you can proceed to perform the sweep. There are many other ways of making the spline symmetrical. For example, we could have joined the control frame points with lines. Make these lines horizontal. And make their midpoints in line with the origin. I will leave you to try out these alternative methods. Could we have avoided performing a circular pattern within the sketch and patterned the sweep instead? On first glance, this does not seem feasible considering the fact that we are sweeping with a twist. Let's try this anyway and see where this leads us. Go back into the sketch and delete the patterned splines. Let's first extrude the cylinder. Let's sweep this section of the profile. Set the operation to join. Let's try performing a circular pattern on this sweep feature. So this does work. Now that we have established that it is possible to do this by patterning features, this means that you will be able to use both feed point and control point splines. So do try these new methods out and let me know your thoughts.